So we're ready to start programming our mice. Cats are pretty good at catching mice, so we're going to need a lot of them to make this game challenging. When new Scratch users make games with multiple enemies, the approach they usually use is to load the same sprite over and over and over again and code each one separately. This will get the job done, but it's a lot of extra work. Every time you try to go back and change the code, you have to change it for every single copy. Fortunately, there's a better way to do this. In Scratch, there's a special control block called Create a Clone of Myself that makes temporary copies of your sprites. These clones all follow the same set of commands, so you can easily make a small army of new mice with just a few blocks of code. Before we get started here, let's confirm that we're actually programming the mouse and not the cat. If we put the next bits of code in the wrong place, our program won't work properly. Just click on the little mouse thumbnail down here in the sprites pane and make sure it has a blue outline around it. You'll also notice that the code you just wrote for the cat is gone, and you should be starting with a blank coding screen. Let's start with a green flag, which will start the mouse executing its program. The mouse you see on the screen right now is the master mouse. I call it the mama mouse. It's not going to move or do anything else that's interesting. Its only job is going to be to sit there very quietly in the background, making copies of itself. To get our mouse making clones, we're going to use the block that I just showed you called Create a Clone of Myself. You'll find it under the orange block category called Control near the bottom of the list. Now we want this clone making process to keep happening over and over again, so let's wrap it up inside a forever loop. Okay, so when I click the green flag, drumroll please, nothing happens. Don't be frustrated. The code is actually following its instructions. It is indeed making copies of itself. The reason you can't see them is because they're all stacked up on top of each other. Before I show you what's going on here, I'm going to temporarily hide my cat so it doesn't get in the way. Just click on this little eyeball tool to hide it. So when I click the green flag and then click and drag on this mouse, you'll see that there's another one right underneath it, and another one underneath that, and another one underneath that. When I'm coding clones like this, I'm always reminded of a Dr. Seuss story called Yertle the Turtle, about a tyrannical turtle king who commands all the other turtles to stack on top of each other so he can be king of the moon. Notice that when I hit the stop button, all the mice disappear except for the master. These are temporary copies, just here for the time you're playing this round. So as soon as the game stops, they disappear. That's actually very convenient. Normally, sprites like this mouse can't actually delete themselves. If we try to delete them from the screen, then we'll lose all the code that's attached to them. But because clones are kind of disposable, we can delete them at any time using code blocks. So we've given our instructions to the mama mouse. But now the new clones are going to be following a totally different set of instructions. If they follow the code that's already here, they'll just end up making even more clones, and we're going to end up with an overpopulation problem that even our hungry cat can't solve. To give the clones their own set of commands, we need to grab a new starter block called When I Start as a Clone. Unlike the other starter blocks that you'll find in events, this block is in our list of control blocks with the other cloning commands. So everything I put underneath this block is going to be instructions that the clones will follow, but the mama mouse will ignore. The first thing we want to do with our clones is not have them stack up on top of each other. There are a lot of different ways we could accomplish that, but what I want to do is have each new clone show up in a random spot on the screen. Under the blue motion blocks, you'll find a block that's made for just that job called Go to Random Position. Grab this block and attach it to your When I Start as a Clone block. I'm not going to show you what happens just yet, because I want you guys to discover it for yourself. I'll be back in a minute and we'll go on to get these mice moving.